Steam Shambles.
Hello, all of my sleepy bears. My name is Chronicles of Boo. Welcome back to more Steam Shambles. You know what time it is. We gotta ask our very lovely person here. Sorry about that. That was TikTok. We gotta ask to pick a number. 122. Okay. Okay, Google. Pick a number between 1 and 122.
Here's a random number. 56.
56 it is. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're at 60. 59. 58. 57. 56. I guess we're going to play LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Now, I got this game because it's LEGO Star Wars. You can't possibly ever go wrong with LEGO Star Wars. But this is the only way to get the complete saga, unfortunately. It's either this or the Xbox 360. I'm not sure if it is available on the PS3 store still. But this is the, you know, this is the one that we all grew up with. You know, LEGO Star Wars, super simple. You know, it's LEGO, but it's Star Wars, and it's cool, and it's fun. And not the Skywalker saga, where it's all, like, you know, 3D, and you choose where you to go, and you, like, you actually choose how to use the Force and such. And, you know, it's big open world. No, it's none of that. This is the regular, walk through a room, screen wipe, you're in a new room. You know, basic stuff that anyone could pick up and play, and no audio. Thankfully. No talking, I should say. So, imagine trying to simplify 6 movies to where it's only explained through actions and grunts. And, yeah, that is pretty impressive, I must say. So, while this is loading, I'm going to go ahead and let it load. And I will see you very soon. Okay, and we are back. Time to go ahead and play LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. So you can start anywhere here. You can start on the prequel. You start on the original trilogy. You can do whatever you like, however you like. And yeah. So it is currently installing this script. And if you've never played a game on your computer on Steam before, this is like what happens. It downloads everything. Then you still have to be connected to the internet to install everything. And after that, you're completely fine to go and mess around and play the games. So if you are downloading games in a free Wi-Fi cafe area, just go ahead and download the stuff. You mean, I cannot believe that this came out in 2009. It feels like yesterday. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Ah, it's beautiful. So we can actually go to the video settings. And we can change resolution to make it perfect. Accept. Look at that. Bam, full screen. We got all the effects on. There's some options if you want to change the volume. I do have a loaded game. I'm going to go ahead and cancel that. We're going to start. Of course, I'm going to skip all the cutscenes. But before you even start, it throws you right into a level. Look at this. It even shows you how long you've been playing the game for. We can buy hints, characters, extras, enter codes for cheat codes and such. See how many gold bricks we have, as well as watch story clips. So we can go right into one. And this actually makes us go through the entire thing in order, which I'm quite happy about. Then we have a little side room over here for a two-player mode for a duel. And if you have another thing, you can go ahead and set that up. We can go ahead and start putting some puzzle pieces together. And this is honestly the coolest part, just seeing everything go together quite easily. Every time you do something cool, bam, you get a stud. And yeah. So we can use the Force in order to get more studs. These little gray ones only give us 10. But for each main thing, there's 6 little levels in there. Those are a little mystery one for when you get everything. But you did not come just to hear me ramble about this stuff. So let's go into the first episode, skip all the cutscenes, and go right into it. Thankfully, we can go ahead and press next. I'm assuming we're on Naboo, or the Naboo space station. As you can tell, I know nothing about Star Wars. Well, that's okay. Maybe in the future, I will be able to play this game as a Let's Play. That'd be pretty cool. Because then I can actually force myself to watch the 6 Star Wars movies, technically, and see how it all works. As I said before, there is no dialogue here, thankfully. So you don't have to worry about subtitles or anything like that. We can just talk through all of it, and that part makes it super cool. And yes, they died. Alright, we can walk up to friendly characters and press Y to take control of them. We can just play the little cantina band dance here, and every time you make something move, you get studs for it, and it's super cool. I really like the fixed camera angle, because then you don't have to worry about going too far. You know, you can just see everything that you can interact with. The Jedis can do a little double jump. We can break this in half, actually. Whabam. And yeah. We can go ahead and use the Force to break this. Now, there is actually the demo of LEGO Star Wars that you could play. And it was not this level. It was a completely different level. But what it allowed you to do is, after you finish the main level, you could then go through in free play mode with all the characters that you were able to access in the demo right from the start. And that part was super cool. Now, there are going to be some locked doors, but you need specific characters. So that'd be fun. And there are some parts that you definitely have to access in order to be able to move ahead. Now, here are these little dudes. What they do, I don't know, but I also really don't care. The only hard part is that sometimes it's hard to... get me up there. Sometimes it is hard to choose where you want the thing to go, which, that's a small... Small downside. Now we can walk up to a friendly character and just press Y if you want to take control of them, or just throw them. That's also fun. Oh no! Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and do this one as well. Look at that. All fancy-dancy. Now, of course, because I'm just showing off the first level, that doesn't mean that there's gonna be anything like super amazing that happens, but you know, it's cool, okay? It's fun, I like it. This is a mini kit, and if you get 10 of them in a level, then things go together. And if you've ever wanted to deflect the shots like in the movies, you just hold the lightsaber button. It's not effective, but it's cool. Now, is it necessary? No, of course not, but you know, who cares? We're here to look cool and have a fun time, okay? And in this game, there's actually power-ups where the Force is faster, as well as you move a little bit faster. And we actually just unlocked the True Jedi, where you get the required number of studs per level. Now we can go ahead and activate C-3PO. And we use them in order to unlock doors and such. That's for R2-D2. But we can take them back to the previous area and have a good old time. Now, heck forbid you and whoever you're playing this with are super competitive. Don't worry. The studs that you collect, they work together. And if you die, you lose studs, so that's not too fun. But this is definitely like the co-op game to play. Before the whole, you know, It Takes Two game, this is what it was. Just gonna go ahead and step on this. And when you step on a button, the computer goes and automatically steps on the button as well, in order to make it easier for everyone, which, very helpful. Just go around here, collect this stuff, do a little bit of Force. So if that happens, then that just means that there's something in the way, or I got cut off by the camera. So we're just gonna go ahead and do that. Okay, now it works. And now we can go ahead and use the Force right here in order to lift this block. Not a lot, but it gives us some extra studs, which we don't need, but you know, It'd be nice if we come back to this. And don't worry, if for some reason I do a let's play of this game, I'll go ahead and start from the beginning. Don't worry. Now this room I never really understood. We do need someone that can crawl into tight space in order to get over there, but we need to try to move these blocks so that we are able to get on top of them in order to get that mini kit. I feel like 3 is good. Oh, but it doesn't matter because we don't have the person in order to go to the tiny little areas, but that's fine. We can still stack them all up. Nothing happens, but it looks cool. Then we're going to need C-3PO again, wherever he is. You know C-3PO, he likes to just walk around, you know. He's like, ooh, I don't really know what I'm doing, you know, I'm just a robot. Now we're gonna use him to go ahead and activate this door here. Go back to Queen Zhongling. If I said that wrong, I'm sorry. What do you want from me? Ah, here we go. I'm gonna use it for C-3PO. Look at that. I'm a genius. Here, go and pick this up. Obi-Wan Kenobi. Gonna go and break these. Yeah, if you have, like, a child or friend that just likes to destroy everything, this is the game for them. Okay, you don't know how much stuff is helpful due to them wanting to break everything. Oh, look, there was a little kid up there. Huh. Yeah. I didn't even know that one was up there. Yeah, again, the game's not that hard. Like, it's not meant to be hard, it's just meant to be fun. Oh no. I'm back. Die. 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 Okay, I guess I'm the one that's dying. Bam! Attack! Attack! Now we can go ahead and mess with this thing here. And the game will allow you to put things in the wrong order. Like, it will happily allow you to do that. It's like, yeah, go ahead, I don't care. Now we are going to need a tiny box on there. Or just a way to get up. Nope, not like that. You're doing too much, kid. But yes, this is here just in case you wanted to go back in. Or, yeah, if you need to get on over there. Got another power-up orb. So, well, funny thing, I don't know if you knew this, but this game was actually released on the DS as well. And they kept it quite intact, actually. Like, they did a pretty good job keeping everything aligned. These are my favorite characters to play as in Star Wars Battlefront 2. I just want to say Star Wars Battle Wars. But yes, I genuinely love playing as them just because you get to roll around a lot. And it is a lot of fun, quite actually. As for all of this, I'm not too sure where all this goes. But it doesn't matter, because we have to destroy these things anyway. To which I just walk right up to them and just say, heck with it. Attack, attack, attack. And then we get a heart. Nice, we got quite a bit here. I want to say we need to destroy the red bricks, but maybe that's just me. Guess we'll fix that. There you go. Okay, no, this is just here for us to get that stud. If we're able to do, like, a triple jump, I guess. There we go. I'm sure that gave us something. Nope. Okay, cool. It's always worth a shot, just to see what'll happen. So we can actually use that in order to get up on over. But I really don't know what this does. Oh, that attracts C-3PO. I'm glad something does. I'm going to step on this, just so we can get C-3PO over. Break a bunch of stuff. And there's more studs up there that we really don't need. But C-3PO is back. Gonna connect him to the mainframe. And away we go. Obi-Wan Kenobi's trying to be all sneaky, and Qui-Gon Jinn is just like, no, not happening. And there we go. That's the level completed. Free play is unlocked. We got TC-14, not C-3PO, I apologize. And that's it. We did get the True Jedi, which is another gold brick. As well as it shows you the stud total that you have now. As well as it will take the minikits that you got throughout the level and start breaking them apart and showing you just like kind of what it looks like. I think that's supposed to be like the little spaceship. Yeah, there's 160 gold bricks in the game. To which, what do the gold bricks do, you might ask? All episodes now unlocked. Well, that's cool. We're gonna go to the cantina. I guess we'll save here, why not? And there are thousands of Let's Plays that show you where the everything is. So if you really want to check it out, you totally can. But I want to show you what is now available in the little areas here, as well as we can go in here and see everything that is available. There's mini kits, hyper kits, and once we get all the mini kits, we will get the other gold brick in that little area, as well as it will show you all the stats total, so you can just stay up to date on everything. So we can buy the gold bricks, actually. The first one. And that's it, I guess. What the gold brick does, I'm not sure. We can enter a code if we want to. There's some extras. Some extra toggles, some fertilizers, a disguise, daisy chains, a Chewbacca carrying C-3PO. We can tow the Death Star, silhouettes, beep beep, and a bunch of other stuff that is locked behind the power bricks. Which, meh, I'm completely fine about. You know, there's only a lot of them. We could also buy characters, like the useless stuff that doesn't do anything. Then we can also get some hints. And it lets you buy a bunch of hints. They're all only 100, so, you know, why not go ahead and do that? There you go. All the hints have now been bought. Cool. Those, we've only been playing for about 14 minutes. And I think that is the perfect time to go ahead and stop. So, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. Please let me know if you are interested by the game. If you want to see me by chance do a Let's Play of it, because if you do, I'll be more than happy to go ahead and turn this into something. But yeah, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. I will see you all next time. Goodbye, my CB Bears. Oh, my schmears.